Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler and welcome to another episode of Farming Simulator 17. We're in our Goldcrest Valley map, and if you notice the local wildlife over here, I'm recording this on Halloween. Remember I mentioned a town full of zombies? Well, something's been tweaked. Yeah, so we're going to see a bunch of them kind of hobbling along our map today. Anyway, last episode we bought all of these guys. Now we need to get them back. So let's hop into here, jump up on the roof. Yeah, that's how you get on the roof. I wonder. I know that there are golden nuggets hidden on various roofs. I guess this is one way to take a peek, huh? Right there. Anyway, zoom back in. There we are. And cab and starter up. My volume up a little bit. I did adjust game volumes a little more. Still fine-tuning this. I'm going to try 30% tractor, 60% environment, and 80% of the master volume. So taking it all down just a little bit. Last time it was a little bit loud compared to my voice. So we'll see how this one goes. So let's hook up this guy, which is easier done from outside because a little better perspective on where you are compared to what's around you. But you need to be able to do it from in the cab too. Basically, this guy is going to mount into that bracket right there. Let's watch that happen. Like so, Q, locks in. All right. And I'll leave it out here so you can watch how these other pieces attach. We're gonna use the fork over there for most of this, but we need to load this guy up. So this guy's tricky. Basically, you hold the left mouse button, right to left will adjust that, up and down will adjust that. So basically, we're something like that. Hook it up. So bring it up, level it off. It takes quite a while to get used to it. I'm still not really proficient with it, at least not on the keyboard. I've never tried a joystick. There are some interesting setups available. Are we high enough? Yeah. Gear that you can buy to run a game like this. In fact, Giant puts out a pretty impressive setup as well. Got an extra $500. You can have your own tractor control panel right here underneath your monitor and feel quite real. Anyway, let's disconnect. Now here's where I mentioned G to choose which implement you're working with. Look down at the bottom right-hand corner of the screen. You see I'm switching back and forth. We want to get rid of the one furthest away from the tractor. So if I were here and I hit Q, the entire front loader mechanism will fall off. If I'm over here and hit Q, I can get rid of that. So that's where it gets important to make sure you know what it is you've selected. Okay. And here I can see things. Bring him down, something like that, and get back to using my pedal again. There we are. Now this is one operation that is really hard to do from the cab. You just don't have a view down here. And if I can get far enough back, you've got to just barely above the ground, about like so, to get in there. As you do it successfully, you'll see 1,000 liters over here in the blue on the bottom right. So that will register as soon as you're within the frame. All right, tip it back, lift up, about like so. If you take off really fast by using the keyboard, you know, full forward or full back, the crate will slip off the fork and go crashing off. If you were to do a quick backward circle, you know, do a 360, this thing would fly through the air and land over there by that blue shopping basket. So you do have to be careful as you're operating these, unless you've got it tilted back far enough to where it's locked in well. But centrifugal force does happen here. We do have some physics involved. High enough? Yeah. So I'm going to do that. Bring him down. There, I'm a little bit too, I think there. Let's see if I can back out. There we go. Network. And I'm going to stop there and hop outside. Got to figure out, I think it's from these points here. Nope, it isn't. So is it random? Pretty much random. This guy's not going to strap no matter what I do. If the R, when he straps down below. He'll not acknowledge this thing. Even if I get it flat onto the deck, he won't acknowledge it. Over here, hit the R, and we strap this in. So, previous versions of this game, you had to drive very gingerly because what you put on your trailers didn't always stay. So I've done a much better job this time dealing with this. So let's drop him down. If you push it down too far, it will lift your tractor like a real forklift will. So you've got to be aware of the strength of those hydraulics there. Let's see, back to my pedal. I'm so used to just hitting that keyboard. Okay, I'm too high or too low? Let's try that. There we go. So curve it in as I go. No, we're still snagging something. Oh, I just didn't want to turn. Okay. So, other way. And up. There we go. So this one, this operation does take some care. It's not something you can just flippantly drive around and smack things around. He'll lose them. Takes me a while to do it. Now, the straps are that distance apart, looking at the orange line, so that's probably a good placement for this one. Let's see if we can get it down. Let's see. I've got to relearn this every single time I click the mouse. Which one is up and down? Okay, right there. Give it that way. Get that guy flat. Try to back out. If you don't, it'll drag off the trailer with you like that was starting to, if you don't have it right. Okay, zoom out a little. Let's grab this guy, the liquid fertilizer. And we'll get this load home. Right there. Okay. I've got to slide my mouse up to go down. Feels like it's the opposite. Okay, let's try this. This is a bigger wooden pallet. So, much more forgiving. This metal one's got just a small little perch in there. Well, that was interesting. Look what it does to the tractor. Whoa! Here you'd almost need a back weight to be doing this, to be doing a lot of it. Yeah. Or this load here, we got 2,000 liters. So if a liter is like a quart, if that truly is liters, then would that be 500 gallons times 8? So 4,000 pounds, that's 2 tons there? Wow. There, pivot down, up, down, back out. There it is. Okay, we're done? Yeah, we're done. Anything else to get while we're here? Don't think so. Let's go lock this load in. Oh, missed it. Okay, so we will tie this one down. I need to scoop that guy around. Though he is heavy enough, he'd probably stay. But we're not going to try it. You know my driving. Alright, so up. Let's see here. How can we do this? Let me get where I can see where things are. You go up. What if we were to just nudge it over without damaging it? The lettuce? Nope, that truly is that heavy. Okay, we're going to do it the correct way. Alright, line up about there. Down. About there. There we go. So I'm going to lift up just an inch. Take the weight off the trailer. It's stuck. Okay, farming simulator. Let's pivot then. Oh, wrong button. Pivot is this way. Wow. Okay. Interesting. I think it's gonna stay. Just saying. All right, so hopefully we can get that thing off when we get back to the farm. Okay, how are our zombies doing? Let's go this way so we can take a look at a few of them. Clear here. Get out of that lane before he gets here. Go. Yeah. I told you. Town full of zombies. Alright. Let's get going. Now we'll let this guy go by. I want to spin off a, let's see. Get up a little higher. Spin off a crate of fertilizer into his path. And cap view. Now let's keep it out here so we can see how these things react to the corner. Anything going to slide? Whoops. See if I can stay on the road. No, everything seems to be locked in pretty good. All right, camp view. We'll have to be sure to come back into town today. In fact, let's take the long route. There's another zombie. See if we can find that stop sign that we lost last time. Though I have stopped the game and restarted, so it's very possible that that the game is resetted. Well, I cannot see a thing here. There we go. That's a little better. So let me know what you think today about volumes, my voice versus the equipment. Now, we're never going to be able to fix the sounds of me versus the outside of a rented or a hired hand running a piece of equipment. But hopefully with just me doing the work, it'll all be fine. Our turn is coming up where those two white dots are off to the left. Oh, blue and white. There was a car in the other lane. I cannot see him there. There's the mirror. Okay. We found that stop sign. Oh, stop sign is back. Whoa, there's a lot of momentum. Wow. I let go and expected to slow down without hitting the brake. Things happy back there? Hope so. So I thought that stop sign would have slid off the tailgate and be sitting right down here. But apparently the game has reset it. The county road crew has found it and remounted it. Said a few choice words about us. So let's take this in, unload it all, rearrange the garage in there, the shelter where we're going to store these guys with the newest stuff to the back. Rotate our inventory. We're going to need a little working room, so let's take this out here. Yeah, a lot of momentum. So, cue that one. Let's see. Wrong buttons. There we go. So, let's think about this. Need to strap those, you know, rearrange these. Probably need to get these put in place first, because I'm going to need my tractor in that position. Okay. R. There we go. These, we'll just... Well, no, I won't leave them. Just in case they'll react badly. Oh, I'm hitting the E. But that's just not happening. Okay. Now, let's get this guy. Oh, I keep hitting my center mouse wheel, thinking it's part of the forklift here. Do that. Get to about there first. No, we're going this way first. Okay. How best to do this? When I filled up the... So we're... I wonder... How... Is that sower finished? We were sowing this field, right? Yeah, that's finished. Okay. And this one has been plowed and cultivated. Let's get him working. Let's do this first. Fresh seed out there, so we'll walk the perimeter. Yeah, so we had a plow going. I did get that restarted when I restarted the game, then I switched over to the store, or the shop. That's right. You want to get from keyboard, you go to shop. Alright, dumping this guy. Fire it up. And we are done. Let's see this here. Yeah, so here's the new volume settings I'm trying. But let's get out here to... What do I want? That one? Yeah, I want the map. 12 is canola. So it did work. The seed is in place. And what's happening here? We're partially yellow, partially wheat. Why would we be partially wheat? I'm a little confused there. Okay, we'll have to check that out. That might be an error. We are partially plowed. That may have something to do with it. Okay. So purple, that has... Okay, it was wheat, and now it has been harvested. And the plow is cleaning that up and turning it into plowed, which will then show up as nothing. Nope, nothing's planted. Okay, that's how that works. So the plow is running. I need to get this guy going. What are we planting next? I think I'd like to get another wheat and or barley. I believe both will allow you to looking this over here. This is the one that was just cultivated. Yeah. I believe that the barley will also allow you to create straw. Hopefully I'm right there. I think both wheat and barley did. Stop a second. The seed down there. Okay. We're using the seed up much faster than we're using the fertilizer. And that's what I was about to say when I got distracted by realizing the sower may not be being used. We go with our plow. Yeah. So I was trying to determine what to put out front, the seed or the fertilizer. I got to think that the fertilizer is probably going to last the longest. So we do need to fill this guy up. Let's see. I think the seed is the one in the middle. I think I can sneak in there. Can I do that from the cab view? So, a little bit more difficult. Yeah, because I can't see those wheels back here. Let's do it this way. There we go. Up in there near the seed. See the doors open up. We'll stop there. And refill? Yeah. So, oh, it disappeared. Well, that answered my question from a couple episodes ago. It does disappear when it runs out. Okay, so if I were to sneak back a little bit deeper, like that, can I get access to the next one? There, we're full. And it did not give me access to the fertilizer, even though we're that close to it. Interesting. I don't really need to fill it up. That should be enough to do a couple more fields. But, so, seed is going to get used up first. That's what I was trying to get at. Let's see, we're going this way. So, probably should put the seed out toward the front. And then the fertilizer toward the back. Let's get wheat or barley. We did wheat last time. Wheat was already here. So, let's think about this. No, that one. Wheat and barley are running pretty much neck and neck. Oh, I did a little research on these. Red is showing you that this is a very low price. This is unusually low, and that is unusually high. Whereas the rest of these are pretty much average for what to expect. Blue means that there is a great demand for that. This particular place has, for some reason, a tremendous need for a certain commodity, and if you bring it over right now, we'll give you a bonus for it. Blue means get on that tractor and load those trailers. So, let's see. In our steaming pile here, I believe that's manure. And silage? Or grass? That might be grass. I'm not sure. It looks like a roll of sod. You got your hay over here. So all these mean certain things. Water? Water? No. No, that's the liquid fertilizer, isn't it? The slurry? I think that's the right word. Not sure what that is. That's obviously yarn right there. Would there be a symbol for milk? If I click in here, can I scroll? No, my scroll wheel doesn't work. I'm not seeing milk. That is a product like wool. Unless that is a milk tank, but I don't think it is. No, biogas. That would be more of the what you'd use for a fertilizer. I want to think slurry is the right term for that. Anyway, wool is selling for a lot. If we've got sheep, if we got animal sheep, I think would be the first one we'd do. So back into here, and so barley and wheat were running pretty much neck and neck. So was it Y? Yeah. Y switches this out. That's wheat. That's barley. Let's go with barley this time. Hire this out. Not a zombie. That's good to see. And pop out of here. Oh, hello. My bad. All right, so where were we? We got the seed going. Plow is still going. Third tractor is over here as a front loader. So let's go get this set up. So seed out toward the front and fertilizer toward the back. Or seed on one side, fertilizer on the other. Now, I think there's only room for me to pull in this side with a forklift and come in over here and drop it. If I got stuff on both sides of this bay, I think I would not have enough room. Unless I were to put it on both sides of this wall, but then I'd have to have two empty bays in order to manipulate it. Now we'll leave it like this. So fertilizer stays to the back is really what I'm getting to. And while I was going to put the new in the back and the old in the front, this has hardly been used. So let's just kind of take it the way it is. So where am I going to get a good view of this? Wrong one again. So hard to get used to these controls. There's so many controls, and I do several games, so I will probably never get to where I'm looking like an expert in this. It's different if this is the game for your channel. You know, then you can really specialize. You put out the money, get the nice wheel, and just get yourself set up, and you do this all the time. So that would be fun to do, especially a game like this. Would have a ball with a game like this. Can I do something with it snagged only that far? Curious, if I lift up, can I drag this out? Kind of. Until it interacted weird with the ground and had a little hiccup there. That's enough to do that. It just said that helper E was blocked. I wasn't looking up there. Was that the original note from when I was there? It would make sense. There. Up. Okay, that's flat. And that's down. Nope. Okay, I need to get in here. Which angle is off? It looks like it's the... Why are you rolling forward? Don't be rolling forward. Okay. All right, back up. Up in the air, that's what I need. And now pivot. He is stuck to it. Okay, we'll take it. All right. Nail lined? Pretty much. All right, that feels a lot better. Tilt it back, come up a little bit. Down. dropped it. I think we're free. There we are. So it is doable when you get used to it. Let's grab the new fertilizer. I do have that right, right? Yeah, they both have a leaf on them. That is the fertilizer. So, you up in the air, not that far. And let's see. Pedals, not keyboard. W and D to walk forward and back, but pedals to drive forward and back. Yeah. Hey, nailed it. I can be taught. Now, if I swing this way, here's where if you just floored it going backwards, that would have just flipped off the fork there. So I don't have it tilted back very far. Can I get past that? Doesn't look like it. There we go. Bit. And let's go this way a little. Right about there. Now it's going to pull back as I go down, so we can go beyond a little bit. You see it'll drag back toward me. Tilter about there. Down. And let's go forward a touch. Right in there. And we're free. Right there. So back out of there. Alright. Let's grab the newest seed. Now, I'm thinking we're going to put the big crate somewhere else. Where would Dave go? That would probably sit outside just fine. I'll fill up that one. Maybe where the wheelbarrow is. I kind of like that. Let's move a wheelbarrow over. Let's see. Let's do this a little more realistically. Yeah. There we go. Yeah. Huh. So, there's still a little bit of growing up to do in this game. It's not quite there yet. Can't tip it back. Alright, you live there. We'll put these two big ones in there. Halloween today. Whoops. Monday, so my day off. I guess Sunday, Monday off. That's the day I do most of my recording. I need to get where I can see that better. So up a little. I think we're in. Okay. And it's kind of a lazy day for me. Is this what I wanted? No, I wanted the other one. But I'll tell you what. Park this guy where he's going to land. That's right. Forgetting to use my pedals again. Somewhere about there ought to be good enough. Alright. Drop you down. Pivot. And down. Can I back out? Yeah. Alright, so flip around. Okay, yep, about like that. There. Ooh, that was real close. So this time, I need to get between two of them. So here's good practice. For a steering wheel would be so nice. Be able to swing in like so. That's why they're all going to be at a little bit of an angle. I should have angled those other ones at the same angle so I can head in and grab them. Yeah, that's going to be a problem later. To get creative getting those out of there. No, I won't have to get them out of there. That's right, we'll just drop a new one in place because they'll disappear when they're done. Okay, that makes sense. So, drop you down, pivot forward a little bit, something like that. So this would be a good bay to park the sprayer and the silver. Like that, and up a little bit. There we go. So I guess I could go out this way. Oh, there we are. So, the big ones. Let's put the new big one in first. Though I haven't used the big one at all. That's for the liquid sprayer, which is one of the next purchases we need to make. As soon as we get to the next stage of growth, we're going to need it. So height about there, down a little bit, something like that. All right, so let's line ourselves up with this one. Feels pretty good. Under it, pivot, lift a little bit, and take this one back nice and slow because we don't have a rear weight on. Let's line that up a little bit better. Can I get all the way past? I can't. Oh, good. Yeah, I like that better. Wages paid, $1,432. Don't want to go in too deep, though, because the equipment's got to be able to ride up along the side of it. So we'll do something like that for our rear one. Like there. Actually, the ground's dropping at an angle there, it looks like. All right, so what's going on here? So down. Nope, that worked. Okay. So, this guy back here, and this job is done. And am I dragging on the ground? I am. I know that I'm pretty well aligned as far as the tines for the forks. Let's try this from here. We'll get the indication down below that we're in. We didn't. Interesting, no blue line down there saying 2,000. So what's going on out here? Because I'm not there. Okay. See, I can't tell that from in the cab. So if I were to go forward now, there it is. It's saying that we are joined with it. So tilt a little, come back up. I wonder if the tractor... Oh, it's added my weight to the back of the tractor, hasn't it? Interesting. So if you're getting tippy, make sure you're inside. Okay. Well, this is going to be easier out here for me, so I'm just going to do this. Alright, that looks good. Yeah, I think we're free. No, we're not. Getting a little closer. What's wrong? If you get, that'll do it. Okay, so that's done. Where would we next use our fork? Not going to be baling for a while. Don't know. Where do we want to store little stuffs? I'm thinking plows and cultivators and those sort of things over there. Sprayers, sowers, seed and chemical related over here. And maybe we'll just put this over here. Deeper in? Yeah. Wonder. I should put it in at an angle, as if I were pulling in from this center bay here, and then tuck over and attach. So, not the correct one. G, now I can release. Okay. And up a little bit, and we'll give it in the cap. I do this from in here? Maybe. It's hard to get the right perspective, though. No. I can't tell my height versus that end of the trailer. Do we have anything we can scoop up with this, just to show how it works? I don't think so. Unfortunately, it doesn't react with dirt. And I really wish that I could, that I could just scoop up a bunch of the road right there and just leave a big gouge in it. I wish that, you know, the terraforming aspect was that real in this game. But I can't think of anything that's around. We don't even have any little piles of a straw left on the ground. So, no, I don't think so. So, I'm thinking for the moment, we'll just pull straight in and drop off the attachment. Right about there, and Q does it. I know, I should have grabbed another weight while I was out there and trucked that one back in too. So, what's next? Sower's over there. We have no more cultivating. No, that's the plow. Let's go grab the cultivator. Plow's done. Though, I'm hesitant to use this tractor. This is the one that has the ability to run the front loader. So, let's not do that. There's a black mark right in the middle there that might not have been plowed. No, that's probably some leftover fertilizer. Something got sprayed, but it wasn't sowed, so that the seeds didn't use the fertilizer up. That might be what that is. Alright, let's go put this away. That is the last of our plowing for now. Let's go for the middle bay. I was going to go for the far one, but a little easier to come all the way out here. Although this one you can pull through. There's an advantage to that. Okay. We'll do this one then. Now this is only for folks that can turn their head fully backwards. If your head doesn't turn fully backwards, it probably won't work for you. How close am I to that wall? Thought I was pretty close. Let's go forward a little bit. Oh, the zoom bounces in and out of the structures. So let's V that one. Yeah, there's room. And Q, and he's done. Roll forward. And let's grab the cultivator. So, into the cab with us. Get to cultivating this field and get the sower in right behind him. Did I not? Start sowing barley? Oh. He was blocked. And he takes a long sweep to turn that thing around. I never expected that. Okay, well, let's get this out of his way. Well, there's a lot of wasted wages there. Interesting. Yeah, he takes quite a long pass there. How are we here? I'd say we're close enough. Send this one on his way. Alrighty. So what else is there for us to do next? Well, let's check, see what's going on out here. Over to the map. What do we want to do? We need to get sheep eventually. Sheep are 4,000 or 5,000 each. What do we have in the bank? 16, 17. Okay. So that's not the answer right now. These guys are being worked on. We want to buy these eventually. We want to buy this eventually. What's going on at 11? Let's see. That, again, is canola. And it is at that last stage of growth. So, no, we're still in that third stage, so nothing's really happened there. Okay. This guy over here, over by the Goldcrest Pacific Grain, where we dumped off last time, or two times ago. 13, you are still in the earliest stage of growth. There's probably something to do there. You're going in with sunflowers. That first stage of growth, I wonder if it'll let us use the weeder there. See, blocked by an object. Me standing there talking. Okay, I gotta get away from these fields. So let's grab our pickup truck, which is where? You know, I don't know. Out here? Where did we leave the pickup? There you are. Oh, we're over here. Okay. And I'm going to go ahead and put that tailgate up. That didn't go as planned last time. And that's quite a loop he's taken there. What would he have done if we'd gone against the rock wall over there? Wonder if we would have recalculated and gone a different route. Where am I going? I'm not going this way. We're going up here. All right, so we're heading over here to the sunflowers. We'll keep it at 35 in here. Just let off on the gas, it comes to a stop that quick. So hopefully that gets adjusted someday. So sunflowers, little diagonal field. Kind of lost it, where am I? 9. Oh, I'm here. That's the first stage of growth? No. Well, I mean, it's just been seeded. So, Well, let's head over to the trigger point. Which is where in this one? Is that this one? No, that's the skinny field between. I think we're down there. There we are. Okay, let's see what we have here. That's not really what I was expecting then. I thought there'd be a first stage of growth in there. Maybe let's see that again. Did I? Okay, we are sunflowers and growing. That's the first stage. Interesting. So I guess first stage just means that it's got seeds in it. I thought I would be able to use the weeder, but no, he wants us to do some spraying for him. Yeah, we'll do this one. Get another, maybe 5,000 out of this. So time is money and all that nonsense, so let's get straight down to business. You want to work? I got a field that needs fertilizing. Job will pay $37.12 dollar sign. So you can tell this is written in Europe. You know, in America, the dollar sign is in front. But, where is this made? I'm thinking Germany, but I'm not sure. Where Giant is. So this is Joshua Allen, field 13, and we've got a little over 9 minutes to do it. Let's get started. All right, so back up, wait, forward, the equipment. There it is. Stop, stop. The other stop. You. All right. So X unfolds. This is quite fancy. Look at that. Little rubber tubes down there that will inject the fertilizer down into the ground. Yeah. We're going to have to do some effective backing up here. I thought it was far enough already with the pickup, but I guess not. Oh, the game is starting to lag again. What is causing that? Well, that's frustrating. I wonder what the trigger is to start that lag. Anyway, V and B. Let's get started. Right about there. Maybe the lag will work itself out. I'll just keep going. Turn. We're going to do some backing up. Unless I just pivot it right about here. Whoa, a little too far. Then we'll pivot it out. There-ish. Yeah, that's not very professional, is it? It'll do the job, but it didn't look pretty. Then, what's ahead of us? I'm seeing trees out there. Trees aren't going to knock over like road signs. Be a little more careful. B turns it off. Out of the field. And back in. Dead end right here. Alright, so crank it over and stop. B, how are we going to do this? Alright, so back up. Wrong way, back up like that. A better plan for this field. Come down the diagonal and just work the perimeter and work the way to the center. Now we, one of these days we may be owning this thing, so we got to think about future tactics. Alright, that was pathetic. Yep. Color me impressed? Well, not me. Okay, so still got the lag. Actually, it's probably a good place just to call this one done. I'm thinking we're in that 50 minute or so range. 45 is probably a good amount of time for an episode. Besides, we've got the other two fields still being worked on over at back at the farm. Maybe we'll let those complete and then pop back in and get a new episode going. Go ahead and record two of them today. All right, well, this has been Noble Rambler. I thank you guys for watching, and I will catch you next time. Bye-bye, folks.